Angela Moss was found her body on the side of California Road, several hundred feet from the nursing home facility where she worked as a nurse. Her fiance, several weeks prior, had talked her into signing over her life insurance policy, naming him the beneficiary. I expected a rest like that. She was left to die on the side of the road over the course of several hours in the dark with a bullet in her head. 3 years and 1 month later, we finally had an arrest thanks to the detectives who actually knocked on the door of the U.S. Attorney's Office and asked them to prosecute when the District Attorney's Office refused to do so. I can tell you those two murders haunt me daily and touched me deeply. I felt so helpless at the time. They're the reason I'm standing here right now. As I was set to leave office, I had a great job lined up back in the private sector. And this description of the Family Justice Center and the job I'm in now hit my desk. And I thought, really? 12 different agencies coming together in a collaboration, cooperating, streamlining, putting everything in one place that a victim needs to escape an abuser, to heal, to find a safe haven, to hold that abuser accountable. We have the only forensic medical unit in New York State dedicated to domestic violence victims. We body map those injuries on an electronic map of the body in combination with high-tech digital pictures. It becomes evidence for the district attorney's office. They're there 5 days a week for our victims who want to hold their abusers accountable. 100% conviction rate in court when this forensic medical unit evidence is used. Exists, they will cop a plea like that, sparing the victim the trauma of trial, right? Many times they're terrorized right out of testifying because they're so scared for their life, saving taxpayers the expense. When these cases go lethal, I can tell you they are frightfully expensive. I know that from my 4 years in town government. We have neighborhood legal services to address custody, divorce, support. You name it, we have it for healing, we have crisis counseling, we have long-term trauma-concerned counseling, we have every manner of law enforcement there, we have a child advocacy center there for the kids, and every day I have the great pleasure of watching people walk out our door headed for hope and for healing and safe havens, and if they can't make it downtown to Buffalo, we have these two amazing satellite offices that were done zero government money by the community, rising up to say, we don't want any more Ossias or Angies. We're going to put our money and our mouths and our muscle behind this mission, and we're going to make sure that the public understands, still suffering behind closed doors, those who are, that we have their back. And again, we're going to do everything in our power to bring them healing and safe havens and hope. And we're hoping we get some VAWA language in there that can help sustain the Family Justice Centers as we move forward, so that we can work directly with the victims and not lie awake at nights thinking about how we're going to fund the Family Justice Centers. Okay?